Dogumentary TV, producing the best breed documentaries.
My name is Dee Gunter. I have Redbone Coonhounds. I also have three of the only show American English Coonhounds in California right now. American English is more closely related to the Bluetick Coonhound. The old guys that hunted them as Redticks still refer to them as Redtick. Up until 1946, your Bluetick Coonhound, your American English Coonhound, which was called a Redtick Coonhound, and your Tree and Walker Coonhound were all the same breed. When the three breeds became three separate breeds, the United Kennel Club, which is called UKC, gave them the name English Coonhound. And then I believe it was 3 years ago when AKC registered them, they put their little twists on it and they made them American English Coonhounds. Your English Coonhound is a combination, they say, of some kind of coonhound, probably a combination of the Bluetick and Tree and Walker Coonhounds, and American and English Foxhounds. They are also used to hunt whatever is the game for that part of the country and what's legal to hunt them with. They are the more outgoing dogs, like the Bluetick Coonhound, and they send to greet everybody with open arms unless you give them reason to doubt you. There aren't that many American English Coonhounds in California. So basically, the three I have are educational animals. The first couple of shows I went to, the announcer said, okay, what is it that we're looking at? And I had to explain to him what it was because up until this last year, nobody had seen an American English in the AKC circles in Southern California. Your Redbone Coonhound is a separate coonhound unto itself. It's a combination of foxhound with bloodhound. They were, according to the history things, they were originally started in Georgia by a man named Redbone. Years ago, when I first started out with Bluetick Coonhounds, I met an old gentleman who had been hunting them for years and years and years. He was in his 70s. He was my mentor. His best friend had Redtick Coonhound. And I always wanted one, but I put off getting one while my ex-husband and I were together because he wanted the Redbone Coonhound. And I always swore because of my love for the Bluetick Coonhound that I wanted the Redtick Coonhound, because basically your Redtick Coonhound is colored like the Bluetick Coonhound without the blue ticking. So it was nice to have the two different colors. Your English Coonhound is the only coonhound breed that can be five different colors. The other ones have got set colors. Your black and tan has to be black and tan. Your Bluetick Coonhound has to be, as I described, of the multicolor. And your Redbone Coonhound can be anything from an Irish Setter red to a deep, deep, deep red with like black masking on it. But your American English Coonhound, they can be white with black, white with red, red ticked, blue ticked, or they can be tri-colored like your Tree and Walker Coonhound, but they have to have ticking on them. The Redbone Coonhound tends to be more aloof than your American English Coonhound and your Blue Tick Coonhound. They don't make up with strangers near as quick as the other two. You have to win their confidence, which makes them a little better watchdog, in my opinion, because they're not as trusting. One story I love to tell is I have sold two of them to families whose daughters happen to be runners for their high school. And I called to check on, because I check periodically on all my puppies when I can. I called to see how this dog was doing. And the mother's first words was, I won't sell this dog for any amount of money anytime. And I said, well, that's great, but what happened? It turns out the daughter was running one night. And the dog stopped and turned around. It was the man behind the girl. And the family insists that to this day, that if it hadn't been for the dog, they think their daughter probably would have been raped and murdered. But that dog showed him his teeth and said, you're not coming up to my girl. And that was the end of it. A Redbone Coonhound is a combination of a foxhound with a bloodhound. And I was told primarily that they were bred for hunting boar. They hunt, all the coonhounds will hunt anything you train them by scent training and live animals that they're not allowed to attack and kill. For all of those that have been told this, their dogs are never allowed to attack these wildlife. They hunt them, but they are never allowed to tear them up or attack them. So your Redbone Coonhound is, as I said, they make a better dog from the standpoint that they don't greet everybody as readily. My work with the Redbone is basically the same thing as a Bluetick Coonhound and the American English. The pups are sold to quite often hunting and pet homes. I myself show them, and I want to do some possibly obedience and some rally work with them. Now, I do have a Redbone Coonhound puppy that I sold a year and a half ago down in Florida, a young man bought him, and he just got certified as a therapy dog. The young man has PTSD, and he is trained to calm him down and bring him back into focus. So he, Copper just got his certification for that, and I'm very proud of that, and he's a Redbone Coonhound. Well, the funnest part for me with all three of the coonhound breeds is the evening. Around 4 o'clock, I go down to the kennels. I have a big exercise yard, and I exercise all of them in sets, depending. All the girls run together, but the boys are done separately. And it gives me a time to romp with them and play with them. And I have a swimming pool set up that they, certain ones like to swim in. And usually it's at that time that while the older ones are out, I train the younger ones to get them used to having confusion around them in the show ring. Besides being hunting dogs and family pets and watchdogs, we've got one right now that's doing agility. A Redbone Coonhound is doing agility. In fact, I gathered placed very well recently at the shows. They're used as therapy dogs. There's a couple of my puppies that are being used as therapy dogs right now. All of your coonhound breeds, but the three I have, all are basically the same size. Females are 21 to 24 inches. Males run 25 to 26, 27 inches. Same weight difference, around 45, 50 on the girls, around 50, I say 55 to 65 on the boys. Even though the standard calls for all six breeds to be the same size, your Bluetick Coonhound, your Black and Tan Coonhound, and your American English Coonhound tend to be on the bigger side of the standard, where your Tree and Walker Coonhound and your Redbone Coonhound tend to be on the little smaller size. Okay, what's specifically about the Redbone is their red color. It's very striking, and wherever they go, they just attract attention just on their coat colors alone. People will stop you on the street and just say, oh my goodness, that is the most beautiful red dog there is. What is it? And of course, that opens up a conversation. Your American English attracts attention primarily in Southern California because, as I said, there aren't that many here. And so they're a novelty. They're very big in the South, but they're not very big in California. They all need the same amount of socialization and training. Hounds tend to be very stubborn. I raised terriers for years, and there's a vast difference between a terrier training and a hound training. You have to have more patience, in my opinion, with the hounds because they are stubborn. And they early on in life, they learn to think for themselves. Because they are hunting dogs, they have to think for themselves and make judgments when their human counterparts aren't around. There's very little cleaning and grooming done on them. I tend to be a little more than some of them. I take the whiskers off. But you have to keep their ears clean and, you know, wash their teeth. And a good bath about every 2 or 3 months will suffice them. Well, they all tend to have what we call that houndy, musky smell from the oily coats. The oily coats, of course, protect them from the element. And they are somewhat water repellent because when they're hunting, especially like deer and raccoon, they go right through the water. All your coonhound breeds are extremely active dogs. So a active family, one that goes camping, hiking, to the beach, romping and playing with each other in the backyard, going to the park. These are the preferred homes for them. They're very good for a single active people, man or woman. I have several of them that hikers own because they make great companions for that hiker that likes to go all weekend long up a big mountain. The dogs go right with them. They're very sure-footed, and their feet are made so that they can take the rugged rocks and hills that the hikers are going up. Jake is my oldest American English Coonhound. He was the first one I bought from a great breeder in North Carolina. And Jake is my big boy. Jake is about 26 inches and weighs in about 85 pounds. Unfortunately, he doesn't know he's that big. Then I have his half sister, Jessie. And Jessie is, I believe she's 25 inches, which is allowed on a female, 24 and a half, 25 inches. She weighs probably around 60 pounds. My Redbone Coonhounds, I have three generations. And there's Cody, who's 3 points off from his champion. Cody is 25 inches tall and probably weighs about 65 pounds. McGraw is about 25 and a half inches tall, and he probably weighs 65 pounds. Your Redbone Coonhound, as I've said, tends to be aloof, but they make fantastic family pets because they are trusting of everybody. Your American English Coonhound is more outgoing and friendly, but again, they will warn you of strangers, and they're very protective of their family. Any of the Coonhound breeds are fantastic from the standpoint they love family, they love exercise, they love going places with you. And thank you.